Well, everybody has good things when you start out on your honeymoon, but once we get into the season and you've been married a while, I don't know what they'll be saying about us. Right now, I think the most positive thing is that all our kids are showing up. And, you know, I mean, let's be honest with it. Not a whole lot of people want to be out here with the 105, 110 heat index, and, you know, we've come in pretty good shape. We hadn't had anybody really get sick on us, so I think that participation and commitment to be out here has been the two strong points so far.
You have to have a good attitude to come out here and practice because it's hot, and so far we haven't had no one has missed so far on the varsity at JV, and I feel that they have a good attitude for practice, and I feel that that's going to help us go a long way this year.
The Red Raiders will have to be ready because they'll face some non-district opponents that will test their team both mentally and physically.
Well, it can prepare you if you're winning and you stay healthy. If you're losing and you have some injury problems, then of course it's going to be a negative factor. So I think it just depends on how the non-district schedule rolls around and how we play. We've got to take it up a notch higher, and that's something that Lee's never had to do, and we don't know how we're going to react to it. There's a different expectations this year than what we've had in the past.
And as far as the honeymoon goes, Coach Peterson would obviously like the trip to end in Irving.
Oh, we'd want it to end up in Texas State in the week before Christmas holidays. Well, that sure would be a sweet Christmas. But, you know, that's what's important is what they're saying at the end of the year, not what they're saying now. You know, I may be calling U-Haul at the end of the year.
It was apparent from Rodney Coleman's opening kickoff return that the Robert E. Lee Red Raiders possessed more than just a will to win today. They simply made up their minds that no team, including Austin LBJ, could hold their own when the Raiders were at their best. Trailing 7-3, quarterback Philip Gossett sucked in the LBJ defense and proceeded to find Rodney Coleman over the right side from 40 yards out. From there on, Coleman did the rest. It was a drive that capped off a 10-7 Red Raiders lead, but the Jaguars were just getting started. On their next possession, Robert Crenshaw put LBJ back on top with a 15-yard touchdown run over the left side to give the Jaguars a 4-point lead. At one point in the first half, the Red Raiders' offense appeared to be slipping and stalling out, forcing them to punt on their next drive. However, it was that punt recovery team led by Tolan Larry, which not only gave them new hope, but point-blank firing range of the goal line. On the next play, Philip Gossett pulled the trigger again, but this time he found Derek Smith in stride to give the Red Raiders a 17-14 advantage. The second half had Red Raiders fans living on the edge of their seat. With less than a minute and a half to go, trailing 29-21, LBJ quarterback James Rogers rolled to the left and unloaded to Cedric Shaw in the end zone. It was 29-27. Of course, a two-point conversion would tie the game, but Red Raiders linebacker John Gilbert had different ideas, and that proved to be the knockout punch that Lee needed. The final from Rose Stadium today, Robert E. Lee 29, Austin LBJ 21.
We didn't really expect to be up at halftime. We expected to pull it off in the fourth quarter. Turns out we were up, I think, 17-14 at halftime. Well, they were dragging. We knew they were tired. Our game plan was just keep it up the gut, keep the defense off the field and the offense on, and just wear them down until we won.
Yeah, it's a big win because now we got everybody in the district thinking about Robert E. Lee. For a while, they sort of forgot about us because the way we was playing, but now this opened their eyes.
And open their playbooks because
12 of high school football, and for the first time in the school's history, they won a playoff game on Saturday. It was the defense that led the way again, holding North Garland on this goal line stand as time ran out.
Oh, this was a real sweet victory. It was just so excited. After I caught the interception, I just went crazy. I was just so excited. Everybody was excited. I don't know, it just, you have to be there to feel it.
The goal line stand is something that's happened to us the last couple of weeks, and I think it's just a belief that you have that you can get the job done.
Defense is doing it all for us. Offense just taking over.
Rodney Coleman should know. It was his 40-yard run late in the game that gave Lee the lead and eventually the win. Something that would overwhelm others, but this group just takes it like a walk in the park.
We believe it's another day at the office. It just happens to be a big crowd watching you work that day. But this group, they don't get too emotional about anything. You know, they don't even sing good together.
We might not seem like we pumped up or anything for the game, but once we step out on the field, it's just like we just changed. Everything just changed once we're out there.
Now they must get ready for Plano, a team rich in playoff tradition, a team that's won two state championships in the 80s.
But those kids aren't there anymore. It's a totally different team. And, you know, we're doing what all we need to do right now, and hopefully we can come out with the upper end of the stick.
Blake Olson, East Texas Sports.
There's a certain thrill which comes from walking down the tunnel of Texas Stadium and onto the playing field. And for some players on the Robert E. Lee Red Raiders, it was a first-time experience when they held a two-hour practice this morning for their upcoming playoff game against Plano.
I've watched a few, Dallas Cowboy games here, but I tell you, it's nothing like being on the field. This place is huge. And I'm glad we got a chance to come down here today. You know, you get a lot of jitterbugs out. I don't know, even me. I came down here along with a bunch of other guys, and first couple plays, we were just kind of in awe.
Once inside, it was business as usual. There was no gawking, no staring, just hard-nosed football. And after all, isn't that why the Red Raiders came to Dallas in the first place?
You're kind of in awe of playing here in Texas Stadium.
Well, just a little, but you got to block that out your mind, because on Saturday when Plano comes down, it won't be Texas Stadium you're playing against. We'll be playing against Plano, so we just got to concentrate on playing against Plano and probably hopefully beating Plano.
I mean, these guys feel like they, you know, there's a lot more that they want to accomplish, and a lot more is really is expected of them than what it was 3 years ago, because that group 3 years ago, they were the icebreakers. I mean, they were the history makers. These guys are the history makers, too, but it's a little bit different after you've been here the second time.
The pregame butterflies that are so often associated with a playoff game can sometimes be a distraction, but on their return trip to Texas Stadium Saturday, the Red Raiders hope to have all those distractions out of the way.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. My music hits me so hard, makes me say, touch this. Yeah, that's how we living, and you know, you can't touch this. Look at my eyes, man, you can't touch this. Yo, let me bust the funky lyrics. Touch this. Fresh new kicks and bands, you got it like that, now you know you wanna dance, so move out of your seat and get a fight going and catch this beat while it's rolling. Hold on, pump a little bit and let the noise go on like that, like that. Pull a little bit, just don't fall on back, let them know that you're too much, and this is a beat they can't touch. Touch this. Why you standing there, man? You can't touch this. Yo, sound the bell. School is in, sucker. You can't touch this. Give me a song, a rhythm, making them fret. That's what I'm giving them now. They know. You're talking about the hammer. You're talking about a show that's hype and tight. Singles are sweating so fast, them a white or a tape. To learn what's it gonna take in the 90s to burn the charts. Legit. Either work hard or you might as well quit. That's word, because you know you can't touch this. Touch this. Break it down. Stop. Hammer time. Go with the flow. It is said, if you can't prove this, then you probably are dead. So wave your hands in the air. Bust a few moves. Run your fingers through your hair. This is it. For a winner. Dance to this, and you're gonna get there. Touch this. Look, man, you can't touch this. You better get a hype, boy, because you know you can't touch this. Ring the bell, school's back in. Break it down. Stop. Hammer time. Touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. Break it down. Stop. Hammer time. Every time you see me, the hammer's just so hype. Magic on the mic. Now why would I ever stop doing touch this.